Today we are making this mushroom duplex recipe. Just look at this guys, crispy from out inside. So juicy it is, you can see the shine on the mushroom. Looks amazing, isn't it? So we are making this at home in cafe style. It will have a juicy, spicy, cheesy flavor inside. Let's get cooking. First, take a bowl and add water. This is about 3 cups of water. Next, we will take salt, about 1 heaped teaspoon, and mix it well. This is our salty water. We will use this to clean the mushrooms. Here I have 1.5 packets of mushroom, or about 300 grams. We need them in even number, so these are 20 mushrooms. You can take one by one and clean them like this, or you can also dump the whole packet and then scrub them with your hands, something like this, and clean them. Done. The mushrooms are washed. Now let's remove the stalk. We will also use the stalk for the filling. If you want to super clean the mushrooms, then you can also peel them like this. But the size of the mushroom will get smaller if you peel them like this, so it's your call. Here I have peeled the mushrooms also. Here our de-skinned mushrooms are ready. Now we have to boil them. Here I have the water boiling. We will add them in and boil it in high flame for about 1 minute. We are basically half cooking the mushrooms right now. Now, after 1 minute, we will turn off the flame, strain the mushrooms, and these are ready for the recipe now. The water in which we boiled the mushrooms is also very good. Don't throw it away. After it cools down, you can also give it to plants. For making the stuffing, here I have a chopper. You can also use a mixer grinder. In this, we will add 1 onion, 4 to 5 cloves of garlic, and 1 inch of ginger. We have to finely chop them. So these are ready. Similarly, we will chop the stalks of the mushroom, not all of them. Since we are making with 20 mushrooms, here I have taken 10 mushroom stalks. Along with this, I have taken half medium sized green capsicum. We will chop this fine also. And here this is done. Now let's take a pan. We will heat on high flame, add about 1 tablespoon of oil. As the oil goes hot, we will add onion, ginger and garlic and cook this for about 2 minutes. Keep the flame high, they will get light golden in color, something like this. Now, we will add the mushroom and the capsicum, some salt, chaat masala powder, garam masala powder, black pepper powder and chili flakes. We will stir this together and cook for another 2 minutes. As we have added the salt, now this will begin to release the moisture. So after a minute, we have to add the coriander leaves. I forgot to add the cumin powder, so I am adding it right now, along with coriander leaves. If you want to flavor this recipe in a different way, you can also use oregano seasoning instead of cumin powder and garam masala. I am making it in the chatpata style. Here you can see the stuffing is also started to dry right now. Looks good. We will turn off the flame and take it out into a plate. Let it cool down for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, it shouldn't be very hot, so we will grate the cheese. Here I am using Britannia processed cheese. About 50 grams we will grate in and mix really well with the veggies. Just be careful guys, the veggies shouldn't be very hot. And the cheese after mixing shouldn't be visible. Here you can see there are no more cheese shreds. Now the stuffing is ready, we will take the mushroom and stuff them. Be generous with the stuffing guys. Here you can see this one is done. Similarly, I am going to repeat with the other mushrooms. The recipe is not short, but the taste will definitely short your taste buds guys. Such a good combination of textures and flavors this recipe is. Here I have done all the mushrooms. Now we will take 2 mushrooms of the similar size, stick them together. If the mushroom is not bite sized, then you have to use 2 toothpicks and pair them like this. If it's a smaller sized mushroom, then you can use just 1 toothpick. Just like that, all the mushrooms are done. Now we will make a batter. For that, here I have a bowl. I am taking 3 heap spoonfuls of cornstarch, 3 heap spoonfuls of maida, some salt, and we will use water to make a semi-thick batter. The batter needs to be in the flowing stage. There you can see, not too thin, not too thick. Now in a large bowl, here I have breadcrumbs. These are panko breadcrumbs with some chili flakes. I made this for the cheesy chili nugget recipe. I'm using the same ones today. You can also use normal breadcrumbs. Now with clean hands, grab one mushroom duplex, coat it in the batter. Let the extra batter drip off. You can also swirl it something like this, and then place it in the breadcrumbs and coat it really well. You can shake the bowl if you want to do it quickly. Perfect, we will proceed with the other ones just like this. You can also make the recipe till this stage. I mean, you can freeze the mushroom duplex for up to 1 month after coating them with the breadcrumbs in an airtight container. Now let's cook them. Here I have some oil heating up in high flame. It is medium hot right now. We will place the mushroom duplex in to deep fry until golden. Guys, after a point, it will start to make a lot of sound because mushroom is full of moisture. That's why it will start to come out. At that stage, we have to take it out. Guys, I forgot to mention, if you want to have a more punchy sort of a flavor in the mushroom, I mean if you want more of a mushroomy umami flavor, then you can skip the boiling stage in the recipe and proceed with the recipe just after peeling them. That way it will have more kick. Here you can see these are golden now. Let's take them out into an absorbent paper. Sounds super crispy, isn't it? If the mushroom duplex is not bite size, you can slice them something like this. See how juicy the mushroom is? Time taking process, I agree, but the end result is worth it, guys. Here I'm serving them up with harissa mayonnaise. So how was the recipe, guys? If you enjoyed it, click the like button and share it with your friends. If you did not like it, click the dislike button. I hope to see you soon with one more video. Bye, take care.